major concern that people have when it comes to using spray cleaners for the intake valve is, where does the carbon go? There's this hypothesis that spray cleaners will break away hard chunks of carbon, which will end up blocking or clogging the catalytic converter. We're going to test that today. I'll be cleaning the intake valves on the 2017 Honda Accord without removing them, using the CRC intake valve and turbo cleaner. I'll be showing before and after pictures of the catalytic converter using a borescope camera. Now let's get this. Intake valves should be cleaned, especially on GDI engines or gasoline direct injected engines, to prevent carbon buildup from the EGR as well as the PCV system accumulating on the valves and restricting airflow. Port injection engines circumvent this by spraying gasoline over the back of the intake valve as it makes its way into the combustion chamber, while on GDI engines, gasoline is sprayed directly into the combustion chamber where it meets up with the air that comes from the intake valves. Now, the traditional way to clean the intake valve is to disassemble the intake manifold and use walnut shells and a special equipment to blast away the carbon from the intake valves. But for the DIYer who may not have access to this special equipment, this may be out of reach, hence the appeal of spray cleaners. I'll start by removing the air fuel sensor so that we gain before pictures of the catalytic converter. I'm going to use this deep 22 socket, which I converted to an oxygen sensor socket. Air fuel sensor is out. We're going with the borescope camera. From this, you can see that the honeycomb structure is pretty much intact and there's no carbon deposits. Fitting this back. So I reconnect the oxygen sensor. And then we'll move on to the procedure itself. I'll be doing everything strictly per the instruction on the can, although you can spray this through the throttle body. I'm choosing to do this through the brake booster line, which is located right here. So I'll get it out of this. I found this rubber thing. I've made a hole on the other side just to form a perfect seal around this. That's formed a nice seal there. I'll just insert that into the hole. We'll start the car. You want the car to be at operating temperature before you start spraying. I was driving this earlier, so the car is already at operating temperature. I'm just going to use this cheetah pipe to get it sitting at exactly 2000 RPM. I'll go start spraying. Connecting the brake booster line. I've lowered the RPM and then I'm just going to rev it three times. One, two, three. I'll allow it idle for 1 minute. That's now up to a minute, so I'll just shut this off and allow it to heat soak for 1 hour. So it's now time to drive this on highway speeds for up to 10 minutes. For a bit of extra kick, I'm going to drive it in sport mode. Yeah, so I had misfires getting off the line as well as these other warning lights. But those have now resolved. I'm not having any more misfires. That's probably due to some of the product that was left in the combustion chamber. Just trying to do a bit of fast and furious. I'm done with driving at highway speeds. I actually drove out again to pick up an oil filter. And upon starting the car again, all those codes are gone. I did do a scan before that though. Let me know if you want to see my analysis of the codes. Also ignore the 5% oil life notification. I've already changed the oil on the car. CRC recommends doing an oil change after using this product. Now, moment of truth. Did CRC break away carbon only for it to get lodged in the catalytic converter? Let's find out. Comparing this after with the before, you can see that it has a darker hue to it, meaning that indeed the exhaust gases did have a higher carbon content. This same dark hue can also be found on the side of the air fuel sensor that faces the exhaust valve. However, I do not see any large bits blocking any holes. Also, I went ahead to drive this car a bit more with the plan to re-inspect the catalytic converter. Here's the car after I drove an additional 40 to 50 miles. As you can see, most of the dark hue is gone, attesting to the fact that the catalytic converter does clean itself off while in operation. My take is that this CRC product does break down carbon to such a fine particulate matter state that although it may deposit on the catalytic converter, these fine particles are quickly burnt off during the normal operation of the CAT. What do you think? Let me know if you have a different opinion or explanation in the comments. Hope this has been helpful. Do consider leaving a like or subscribing if it has. Catch you on the next one. Peace.